Here's an idea. What if there was a West Dakota?
Todd, isn't that a job for the State Department?
Well, I got a whole page of other ideas, each as impractical as they are prohibitively expensive.
What about if marbles were cube-shaped so they don't roll away as much?
You know what else would be cool? A miniature cupcake gun, so you could shoot tiny cupcakes into your mouth. Uh-oh, is that guy trying to kill himself? Nope, just a cupcake gun.
But then I thought, why isn't there a Disneyland? People would love it. So I took matters into my own hands, and over the last 5 years, I built my own Disneyland.
Okay, but you do know that there already is a Disneyland.
Yeah, I built it. And here we have Cinderella's magical pile
of used mattresses.
Is it a good idea to keep all those mattresses so close to an active grease fire?
Where's your sense of wonder, Diane?
We have gathered in Todd's new apartment to discuss the future of PB Livin'.
You told me this was an intervention to get Todd to stop coming up with awful ideas.
Oh, that was just a pretense to get you to show up.
What?
It was Todd's idea. What else you got, Todd?
So you know how hard it is to get your kids to go to the dentist?
I don't.
But what if dentists had a friendlier face?
Ooh.
What if you could take your kids to a dentist's office where all the dentists were clowns?
Ah!
Oh, hey, Princess Carolyn.
What is going on here?
Only the future.
We've received complaints from several concerned parents. It seems that many of your clown dentists aren't actually licensed to practice medicine.
Isn't laughter the best medicine?
No.
Has this ever happened to you?
No. Whatever it is, it hasn't happened. Nothing has ever happened to me. Stop.
You say you love a toasted bagel.
Anyone else got any bright ideas?
I don't know. This is probably stupid, but the whole story is about how this guy's in love with this lady, right? But we don't even know who she is or what she wants. I mean, maybe give her more lines or words or, I don't know, feelings or whatever.
What?
He's new. He doesn't know the rules. Forgive him, mighty Caesar.
Yes. Yeah. I love you. Who is this kid? You're a genius.
Basically, it's Tommy by way of Cirque du Soleil, set in space with heavy erotic overtones and the gripping psychodrama of a thriller with plenty of heart and more than a little humor. I call it Newtopia Rising.
Traveling on a spaceship.
I'm in.
I'm out.
Remember that idea you had about the dating app for asexuals?
Nope.
Yeah, here we go.
Dun-dun-dun-dun.
All about that ace?
You should get yourself out there. You were the best boyfriend I ever had. If only there was a version of you that I could have sex with, I'd be all set.
Whoa, Emily. I just got a crazy idea.
What?
I was gonna see if he wants to make instruments out of shoeboxes and rubber bands.
You know what I'd do if I had $8 million?
Yeah, you'd give it to the waitress.
Oh, no. I mean if I had $8 million now.
I'd start a company that makes remote-controlled drones. But these drones have a seat hanging from the bottom so you can fly around in it.
A drone with a throne. A drone throne.
Mr. Peanut Butter.
He's a sex robot.
What?
I love it when you call me father.
Oh no!
My wacky scheme backfired as always. Oh, if you want something to do, you could help me find a job.
You are looking for a job?
I spent all day looking. First, I thought I should get a newspaper to find a job, but then I was like, where do I find a newspaper? So I looked it up, and a map came up in my local area, so then I thought about how I know this area pretty well, but there's all kinds of areas I don't know, like South Africa.
Okay.
And then I thought about Charlize Theron.
Right.
And then I thought about that movie Monster, and then I was like, what year did that come out? So I went to monster.com to look up facts about the movie Monster, and it turns out they have job postings there. What a time to be alive.
Thank you so much.
Oh, crap! I accidentally tipped a waitress $8 million. Well, Guess I'm broke again.
Some make it when they